Mr. Ram Jaitmalani, by choosing to defend Manu Sharma, are you in some senses defending or attempting to defend the indefensible?
Who the hell is the press to decide who is indefensible? Courts decide that, and courts decide it after hearing the lawyers. The lawyer's duty is to assist the court to arrive at a conclusion. The press has no right to determine this issue. Press, in trying to determine it and declaring it to the people, is guilty of the highest form of contempt. I am a great lover of the press and a great lover of freedom of speech and expression. But please recognize your limits. The worst commit that you contempt that you can commit is the contempt of prejudicing mankind or the public mind against a person who is standing in his trial for life. You have no business to go about telling people that Manu Sharma's case is indefensible. Every case is indefensible. How do you know?
But sir...
And who the hell are you to decide this? I want to know. And I want to ask your proprietors who are running this show, what right have they? Have they the means of deciding? Have they heard the witnesses? Have they read the evidence? Have they read the cross-examination? Have they read the defense?
But sir, aren't you worried that you're going against the...
I'm not worried at all. It is my duty. If I will be worried if lawyers of this country decided not to defend people.
But
you don't know the rule of law. You don't know democracy. You don't know anything. And I'm sorry that the press is behaving like...
But the press is only reflecting public opinion.
I'm sorry, public opinion must stop.
In the eyes of the public who is seen as committed a heinous crime.
I'm sorry. Who did you... Did you see it?
No, sir, the evidence, some people believe that the evidence so far...
Now, some people may believe it, but that's nonsense. There is no evidence. Why has the judge acquitted? You wait and see the judicial verdict. And don't jump at conclusions. It is none of your business.
But sir, you have gone against your own family. You are going against the tide of
public
opinion.
That is my courage.
You are going against the citizens of
India.
That
is my moral courage. Who are the citizens of India? You are not the repositories of the citizens of India. And I decide according to my conscience who to defend. And please understand and tell those people who are asking this question that there is a statutory rule of the Bar Council of India that a lawyer who refuses to defend a person on the ground that people believe him to be guilty is himself guilty of professional misconduct.
As a criminal lawyer, don't you believe that there is a Lakshman Rekha that even all criminal lawyers have to work under?
I'm sorry, don't please talk of this bullshit to me. I know what my Lakshman Rekhas are. I have read my rules of the standard of conduct of a lawyer. It will be the saddest day when a lawyer refuses to stand between the state and the final verdict.
So what is precisely making you angry that he should be found guilty in the eyes of the law and not in the eyes of the press?
What is making me angry at the moment is what the press is doing.
But what is the press
doing? What you people are doing, you are carrying on a sedulous campaign of creating prejudice against a man who is standing his trial and who has already been acquitted in one court.
But sir, a number of lawyers who have in fact been participating in the team have pointed out to us that in fact the evidence that is there against Manu Sharma is enough. That the testimony of Veena Ramani is enough. That the fact that he's...
I'm not impressed. What you should do then is to go and talk to the police, come to the court, give evidence, if you have any evidence to give. But don't merely go on creating this kind of a confusion.
There have been tapes that have been done by various investigative agencies showing that in fact the witnesses are all falsified.
Those tapes are not worth the paper on which they are written. The police can manufacture any confession. That is why our law is that confessions recorded or kept by the police are not to be looked at. You are trying to look at inadmissible material, causing prejudice in the judicial mind when the judges have no right to look at that evidence.
Mr. Jaitmalani, the press at the end of the day, after all, is only expressing the opinion of the Indian public.
Go on expressing that opinion till eternity, but I am Mr. Ram Jaitmalani, who does not go by the opinion of the press. When my own professional duty is concerned, please do not ask me to surrender to your opinion.
But what makes you so convinced about the innocence of Manu Sharma?
I don't have to convince myself. I am only convinced that the man is entitled to a fair trial. He is entitled to the services of a good lawyer, and his lawyer, the courts will decide. No pressman will decide. No editor will decide. No television crew will
decide.
But
it's the High Court that has decided. The High Court took cuomo to cognizance. The High Court took cuomo to cognizance.
Nonsense. The court has found him not guilty, and you are going against the court. You are trying to become the court.
So the press.
You are not the court. Please understand this. I will not allow you to use up the judicial function, which you are trying to do just because there are people who are afraid of making press their enemy. I don't care. You can write 100 things against me. I will stand by my client and I will defend him to the last breath of my life, okay?
So, are you basically fighting the press or are you basically
fighting...
No,
I'm fighting for my client. The press is fighting for injustice.
The press is fighting for injustice.
I will not allow you to perpetrate an injustice.
But is this how you want to be known in the public eye? Your family
itself...
Your family itself...
Please don't ask me how. It is my personal life, professional life. You have nothing to do with it. I will not allow the press to control my life.
It's not just the press, it's your own family which has said that they don't want you to take off the case.
It is between me and my press, you have nothing to do with it.
The press has, you're right, been taking an undue interest perhaps in this particular case. But the evidence that so far exists, Beena Ramani's testimony is there.
I will not discuss the evidence with you in the case. That evidence is to be decided by the court. When the court will hear arguments, you are nobody to comment on the evidence. If you have read the evidence, come to a conclusion, keep that conclusion to yourself, broadcast it on the television, but you will not influence me. Okay?
So is that at the end of the day what is bothering
yes,
you? The press
is wrong. Nothing bothers me. What is bothering
but
you?
But what is wrong with an activist press?
But you go home.
What is wrong with the press that speaks up for the underdog?
Be activist, but it is my duty to
but
inform
what about
you.
Your own conscience? Why don't you search your own conscience?
But I am searching my conscience.
A young girl was shot in the presence of 100 people.
Please don't. This bullshit will not convince me at all. My conscience is my conscience and you are not responsible for my conscience. And I don't sell my conscience either to you or to anybody else. Nor will I change my professional etiquette, give up my professional etiquette, because some chip of a girl comes and tells me that something is wrong. I'm sorry.
What about the case in itself? A young girl was shot in public. There are some witnesses who believe that Manu Sharma was involved.
It is none of your business. The courts will decide. You are not the judges of this country. And for God's sake, stop becoming judges and gods. You are overstepping the limits of your duty.
Tell us, why do you feel that this is a case of public interest?
I am not going to discuss this matter with you. I am not supposed to discuss it with you. It will be wrong of me to discuss it with you. It is wrong of you to invite a discussion.
But you are not giving me an answer. Why are you defending Manu Sharma? I am
defending him
questions.
Because
he
is my client. I am a lawyer.
You decided to take him on as a client.
I will. It is my right and my duty. Because you don't know the duties of a lawyer. You have not read the statutory rules of the Bar Council. You don't know a word and I am not prepared to discuss.
What about the peer Darshini
case? Now please, I am sorry, but don't talk about other people's cases. I have nothing to do with the peer Darshini case. I have not read it. I am not involved. And I don't discuss other people's cases.
So you have taken on this case because you are angry at the way the press has been trying him?
Now that is very stupid and it's a big lie. I never said anything. But I am angry with you. I am angry with you for the simple reason that A, you are creating a hype that the accused is guilty. You go ahead if...
But in this country where the high and mighty get away with so much, where witnesses are paid off, where the high and mighty buy the process of justice, where the press is a sounding board, the press is the only recourse.
Now you see, you can give yourself all the tributes that you want. This is self-praise. By all means, adopt it, pocket it, publicize it, take credit for it. But when you are doing something wrong, I will say that you are doing wrong. I have the liberty in a democracy. People have the liberty to go wrong.